Introduce myself, called Max Tokuingua. I'm one of the analysts here at Treasury. I joined as a graduate at the start of 2020, so just before all the COVID stuff hit, and it was, I mean, a very, very fortunate time to get a job, especially here at the Treasury, which was like, really felt like it was the center of that whole response. And it was really cool getting to see that whole process of figuring out how to respond to a pandemic. And that's still going on. And now there's the war as well, over in Russia, Ukraine. I just came from a talk that our chief economist was doing on the impacts of that war. Some really interesting stuff going on here. So kia ora koutou. Hi. Hey, Kara. I just caught the end of that last bit. You doing well?
Yeah.
showing us off.
I'm hoping to pull as many of us in, as many more Māori Pacific grads as possible. But yeah, everyone knows who I am, obviously, if you were tuned in just before to the panel session. Kara, if you're up to work at the Treasury as a manager in the Te Ao Māori Policy and Strategy team. Keen to have a kōrero with Max about all the awesome stuff he's been up to, but I might just hand it over to Laura to kind of set the scene.
Good everybody, and thank you so much for joining. So today we thought we'd rather than hear from me, and I do talent acquisition at the Treasury, so I look after all of our intern and grad recruitment and generally up to analysts, senior analysts, and our principals. But I thought what would actually be really interesting is just a kōrero between Kara and Max. So Max joined us a few years ago in the grad role. He's now an analyst with us and he's in the Agile team. So he's moved into a few different roles, seen lots of the work that Treasury does and can really speak to the experiences of our grads and as they move through the organisation. Kara I've known for quite a few years as she's been at Treasury, left, came back, and it's been really cool to see that journey as well. But as a manager at Treasury, I'm really keen to hear her side of things as well. So what they're going to do is QA each other. We've got a few questions that they're going to talk about and share their experiences. But also we've left quite a bit of room at the end to answer any questions that you have. So feel free to ask away. No question's a bad question. And also we've prepped them with some curly ones if you want to know the answers to some curly ones. So just ask away, enjoy, participate. But yeah, great to have you here. Cheers.
Ora. So when Max and I were preparing for this, we realised that we can probably talk for a lot longer than the session allows us right now. So Laura, please do jump in if we do not get through everything or we just keep going on and on. But Max, I have the lovely, not opportunity, but I have the privilege to ask you, in your own words, what does the Treasury do?
Gosh, it's a big question. What we do, because there are so many different aspects to the Treasury. We've got a lot of different functions, but one of the central things is that we are what's called a central agency. We sit right in the middle of government, and we have our fingers spread throughout the rest of government. The pie is all over. When I first joined, I was Treasury's vote analyst for the primary industries. So my job was to engage with the Ministry for Primary Industries on all of their policy and all of their finances. It was about providing this economic perspective on policy going to cabinet, but also about helping the government manage their finances. And mine was focused on that ministry, but there's a lot of different people that focus on other ones from across the sector and helping ensure that the finances of government go well. But then we've got parts of our business talking about the commercial performance of commercial entities like KiwiRail. And we've got people in capital markets thinking about how do we raise billions of dollars to pay for like all of our services that the government provides. In my first couple of days, I sat down and watched a bond sale where they raised, I think, $12 billion in front of me. It was crazy.
And you did that as a grad.
Well, I was watching them. It was a grad from the capital market showing us just like one from the year before. Yeah, it was quite cool. So like a whole bunch of different things, but we're really like in all of those different areas and do a lot of working with different people.
Yeah. Hey, we've just had a question come through. Sorry, Laura, I'm jumping in. From Lay, how often you are working with the Reserve Bank and how you describe your connection with them? Have you done a lot of working with the Reserve Bank there, Max?
I've done very minimal working with the Reserve Bank. I know there are specific teams at Treasury, like our macro and fiscal, macroeconomic and fiscal policy team that do a lot of work with the Reserve Bank. I did a little bit with them in COVID times when we were developing a way of thinking about how to talk about the state of the economy on a like really fast and up-to-date way. So we worked with them on developing a dashboard to go out to the world to say, this is what New Zealand's economy is like now. But otherwise, not that much. Like everything else has been with other agencies.
Yeah, we've worked quite closely with the Reserve Bank from a Māori economy perspective. And we actually run a hui with Māori business leaders and iwi leaders alongside Dr. Carole McLeish, who is our Secretary for Education, and the Governor of the Reserve Bank, Adrian Orr, and his team. So we all come together and have this way to share insights across and within the economy, which is really, really cool. Ordinarily, like before I got into Treasury, I really didn't know what the Reserve Bank was or the Treasury. So it's been a really cool learning experience being privy to these conversations that normally wouldn't. Max, can you describe a typical day at the Treasury for you?
Yeah, totally. So typical day is broken up, maybe like a third of it is spent sitting in meetings, talking to people. I'll come in and do a bit of morning sort of figure out my email, see what I need to do for the day. And then I'll go between sitting down and focusing on some work, writing, reading, thinking. Sometimes I stand at a whiteboard. I've got my whiteboard marker here. I love it. Drawing big pictures about what's going on, and then going and talking to people, because Treasury's got so many smart people that are just so interesting to talk to. I mean, Carter's just one of them, but it's quite cool, and there's so many people to learn from. A bit of that. I have lunch at some point. At some point during the day, hours are very flexible here, so you're given a lot of like agency to just spend your time as works best for you. So I take lunch when's best, often go for a walk in the sun if it's sunny, which isn't always the case. At 3 o'clock my team does the afternoon quiz, which is a staple of the I think government in general, but it's a big thing at Treasury too, the quiz in the afternoon. And then wrap up when I'm ready. For me, I like a 9-to-5 day, but others do quite different hours, depending on what works. I mean, Kata, you've probably had some different, you work from home a lot. I come into the office all the time, but you must be quite different.
I am a little bit different. I am the mother of three. Having the ability to work around dropping off the kids, coming back to log on, and then run and have hui, try and make a break as much as possible. Cool thing about Treasury, whether at home or in Treasury, is coffee machine. Another privilege of working in Treasury, we have this machine called, we name it Frankie, but you know, you get hot chocolates, you get cappuccinos ready there in each kitchen. And then I'm usually checking in a lot with my team along the day, and I run to school time. And so once I have to go pick up my daughter, I might log on a little bit later and then finish off some stuff. So that ability to kind of juggle around that life balance has been really good for me. It's been really cool. And no one day is really the same. which is another cool thing. But like what Maxie, but you can meet with so many different people. And in our teams in particular, Max and I work in a kind of a different type of team. And maybe Max, you can talk to that. But you work with a whole lot of teams. But Max, you want to explain your team dynamic?
Yeah. Kara and I both, my team's called the Agile team, but we both work in quite similar teams in that we're basically in-house consultants for the Treasury. So we had this, we were like trying to share with the rest of the organization what our team does. And we made a picture of us, our faces photoshopped on people getting dropped out of helicopters because it's like we're getting dropped into the other parts of the organization to work with people on what they're doing. So we do a lot of the like go in, help figure out what's going on, like provide a new different perspective. That's a key one for you, Kara. For us, yeah. It's a lot of the just going into to help where they need help and drive some policy processes. Because there are lots of teams around the building that have things that are urgent or need happening in the next few months and need a push.
Yeah, that's it, isn't it? Like we definitely work on such a wide range of different things, from parliamentary questions, from select committee question, to the need of policy development and around macroeconomics, to the budget, to well-being and what that looks like. There's just so many moving facets of the Treasury, and in our particular teams we have the opportunity, if they need help, if other anchor teams have need help or a particular lens, we're able to go out to those teams for a certain period of time, deliver on whatever's required, and then come back and get deployed out to another team. So it's real fun. You get such a wide range of topics to look at. But what's been your favorite project to work on? Your career highlight?
Oh, that's tough. Thankfully, no one else is here to listen to me play favorites. I think one of my favorites was quite early on. I mentioned it before. It was when the pandemic really hit, the Treasury set up this new team called the COVID Monitoring and Insights Team, which was there to support our COVID policy team do work and also provide this sort of external facing, what does the Treasury think the state of the economy is? And I got in and the manager was like, we need you to do these things. And I said, I don't know how to do them. And he said, that's cool. Learn. So I did, and like he gave me time to go and I learned how to code in a language that I'd never heard of before, just for the role. And it was just super cool getting given that like space to learn. That was and it was what, four or five months into my job, straight out of uni. It was awesome.
That's amazing. Yeah. Exposure. That's so cool to grow yourself in that way.
What about for you?
A career high? Oh, yeah, like you, I've been privy to so many good things in Treasury, ranging from social housing reform program, working in commercial operations. I have a social policy background, so working in commercial operations I thought would be a different language, and it wasn't. It wasn't as bad as I thought it would be. It was really, really cool. The team was really fantastic in helping grow my skill set, but also a lot that I could share with them too. I really enjoyed my time on that social housing program. But I think career highlight for me is the Ivan Kwok Awards in the Treasury, acknowledging the good Crown Māori relationship work, treaty work, a whole lot that goes along across the Treasury and celebrating the success of that. And so if you've ever had the opportunity to be with or hear of Ivan Kwok, he is a legend in Crown Māori relationships, and he worked for the Treasury for a very long time. And we've got this award that we give out every year that kind of celebrates the essence of what he really pushed. And it's fought over quite No, it is a bit, it's a bit of a competition. It's a mana builder. You know, everyone says it's not, but yeah, it is. It's the mana of having that award is so well celebrated. And that's been a highlight to keep that alive and going on across the Treasury. But, you know, there's one group that, we do share as well, Max, which is Te Punawai. What kind of groups and stuff do else do we have in the Treasury that we can share with others?
Yeah, Te Punawai is a good one, our Waiata group. That's a lot of fun along the way. a lot of fun. We also have quite cool like intellectual groups. We've got a Let's Talk Economics and a Let's Talk Public Sector that get together every month-ish, and that we bring in speakers from across the public sector or academia to talk about issues. Basically, it's like, you know, what is the role of local government, and people chat about that over lunch. Like, you bring your you bring your noodles or something, and you have a corridor about whatever the topic of the day is, and it's just so cool seeing everyone get excited about that.
Those
are some good ones. But then we've got a couple of different networks and groups, like the Rambo Network and the Government Women's Network, which goes across government as well, which are some really, really cool ones that hold events and do things to celebrate. We had on Pink Shirt Day last week, we had colourful cookies, I think, which was something.
Rainbow cookies, they were fantastic. And you decorate them and share them with your team. They were really cool. We also have Te Puna Arunui, which is a kind of a collective of Māori and Pacific experts within the Treasury. And then we come together regularly, like twice a week, to kind of just share what's going on, how we're feeling, what we could collab on, the synergies. So there's just lots that you could definitely jump into at the Treasury. And I think Max and I are pretty much, we attend most, if not all, of those.
We've got to wrap up now, Kara.
I've just seen that. I was like, right.
Gosh, it goes by very quickly. So do you wanna take on the technical, this is how you apply to stuff?
Where is that question?
This is from Laura in the chat. The grad intake is wrapping up now, but the intern applications are kicking off in August. And also general roles outside that will be advertised around then as well. Or just throughout the year, you can look up roles from policy analysts through to your corporate functions, IT, that kind of thing, TAs, all of it. Those general roles will be advertised throughout. But each year the grad intake comes in, and I highly recommend, I think it's early in the year, around the March, April is the application time. But give it a go, because it's such a cool place to work. We have a lot of fun, cool people. It's a great opportunity. All the other agencies also, they say, oh, you worked at Treasury. Very cool. I'm gonna hire you. Yeah, it's a big sell.
We're a good sell point. How am I? We need you.
Yeah.
All right. I'll just jump in there at the end and just say, all of our grad applications have wrapped up, we think, for this year, but there may be one or two more jobs that we list throughout the year. So if you create a profile on our account, it means that anything that suits your interests or skills, you'll get a notification from the system saying, get in and apply. So rather than having to check our website all the time, it will give you a prompt. So that's quite a helpful thing. But thank you, Kara. Thank you, Max, for sharing. That was really cool.
Thanks, Max.
Thanks for the opportunity.
Yeah, our podcast will come out soon.
Very good.
All right, kia ora.
Cool.
Thanks, Laura. Thanks, Sam.
Awesome. Cheers, Laura, Max, Carr. That was a fun session, I must say. But thanks for jumping on. Huge value there.